Shravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today we're going to begin chapter 15 of the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. We'd heard how Lord Chaitanya took part in the Rath Yatra, and we heard about the significance of the Rath Yatra. So all the devotees had come from Bengal, about 200 of them had come to be with Lord Chaitanya, and they came for the Rath Yatra, but they stay for the 4 months of the Chaturmasya.
我们就听说了，在孟加拉的两百位奉献者，他们全部都来这里参加了Radha Yatra。然后呢，他们虽然说来参加这个节日，可是呢，他们会在Jagannath Puri会住上整个四个月的Chaturmasya，就是四月五行的这个时间。While
Lord Chaitanya was staying at Jagannath Puri, he would every day enjoy chanting and dancing with the devotees there.
当主在加克纳布瑞的时候呢，他每天都会和在那里的奉献者们一起尽情的唱诵和跳舞。In
the beginning of the day, Lord Chaitanya would go to see the deity of Lord Jagannath.
在一天之始呢，主查坦尼亚马布会先要去到庙里面去觐见主加格纳特。And
he would offer his obeisances and offer prayers, and then he would chant and dance in front of the deity.
然后呢，他会向主顶拜，向主献上祷文，然后呢，就会在主面前唱诵跳舞。And
when they would, of course, when they make offerings to the deities at that time, you cannot get darshan, and they'll get the devotees to all go outside the temple while they offer the food to the deity.
当然，在向神像在供奉食物的时候，这会儿是不能够搭讪神像的。
So during that time, Lord Chaitanya would go to visit Haridas Thakur, who was residing on the beach at Jagannath Puri. Haridas Thakur used to sit and chant the holy name under a tree there's a special tree which is still there. It's called the Siddha Bakula tree.
Haridas Thakur, he usually sits on a tree on the seashore, in this tree, and chants. So this tree is a very important tree. Until now, this tree is still there. This tree is called Siddha Bakula
tree. Yeah, the type of tree is called Bakula, and Siddha means it's a perfect. It's a perfect soul in the form of a tree.
那这棵这种树，的种类呢是巴库勒树，但是Siddha的意思呢，就是它在树的身形中是一位完美的灵魂。Yeah,
it's like an eternal, you know, it's like a spiritual body. It doesn't die. It's been there for many, many years.
它就好像是已经具有了它的灵性的躯体，也就意味着它一直都不会死去，它都已经在那儿屹立了很多很多年了。Well,
you can understand, since the time of Lord Chaitanya and Haridas Thakur, so that's more than 500 years ago.
所以我们可以理解，如果要是这棵树在Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu和Haridas Thakur 在世的那个年代就已经在的话，那也就意味着这棵树已经存在了500年以前了，500年了。
And so you can still visit that tree when you go to Jagannath Puri. We go to see the tree and offer our obeisances there and chant the holy name.
那所以我们依然还是可以去拜见这棵树的。如果我们要是去 Jagannath Puri 的话，我们就可以去参拜这棵树，顶拜这棵树，并且在这棵树下唱诵圣名。
So after Lord Chaitanya would go to see Haridas Thakur, then he'd come back to his own room and he would sit there and he would chant on his beads.
当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 看完了 Haridas Thakur 之后呢，他就会回到他自己的房间里，并且在他的房间里面开始念诵。
And Lord Chaitanya would sit there chant, and Advaita Acharya would come there and he would begin to worship Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢会坐那儿念诵，然后呢 ，Advaita Acharya 会来到这里，并且开始崇拜主 Chaitanya。
So Advaita Acharya is much older than Lord Chaitanya. Advaita Acharya is like, on the level of his grandfather.
Advaita Acharya 的岁数要比 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的岁数要年长很多，就像是他的祖父一样。
Instead of Advaita Acharya, he was responsible for bringing Lord Chaitanya here.
是 Advaita Acharya, 他负责把 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给换到这个物质世界的。
He called him to come to help deliver all the fallen souls.
他呼唤着主来到这里，来帮忙解救所有的这些堕落的灵魂们。
And after Lord Chaitanya disappeared from the world, Advaita Acharya was still here.
所以呢，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 从这个世界隐迹之后呢， Advaita Acharya 依然还在呢。
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was only in this world for 48 years.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他只在世了48年的时间。
But Advaita Acharya, he was in this world for a long time.
但是 Advaita Acharya 他在世的时间很长。
So Advaita Acharya would worship Lord Chaitanya by offering scented water, first of all, to wash his mouth and to wash his feet.
那么 Advaita Acharya 他在崇拜主的时候呢，他首先是用香水来崇拜主的，用香水为主漱口，然后为主沐洗他的莲花足。
And then he would smear a very fragrant sandalwood pulp all over the body of Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，他会用非常香的，就是很芬，就是有很好的芬芳的这个檀香浆液，然后呢，用这个檀香浆液抹遍你的全身。
And then Advaita Acharya would put a flower garland around the Lord's neck, and he would also offer tulsi flowers, manjaris, on his head.
然后呢，是一些他Advaita Acharya 呢，他就会把花环戴在主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的脖子上，然后呢，把凸起的这个小花 Manjari 给放在主的头上。
And then he would offer his obeisances and he'd offer prayers to Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，他向主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 顶拜，并且呢，向主 Chaitanya 献上祷文。
So Lord Chaitanya would feel uncomfortable when Advaita Acharya would worship him like this.
所以呢，当Advaita Acharya 在向主献上这样的崇拜的时候呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是觉得挺不舒服的。
Remember, Advaita Acharya is the incarnation of Mahavishnu and Sadashiva, so he's also Vishnu Tattva.
那记得 Advaita Acharya 呢，他是 Mahavishnu 的化身，也是 Sadashiva， 所以说呢 ，Advaita Acharya 他也是属于 Vishnu Tattva 这个范畴的。
And in the Panchatattva we have three Vishnu Tattvas. We have Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, and Advaita Acharya. They're all Vishnu Tattva.
所以说呢，在五圣体里面有三位都是属于 Vishnu Tattva 的。Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Nityananda, and Advaita Acharya.
Vishnu Tattva means like they're on the level of the Supreme Personality of God.
Vishnu Tattva 的意思呢，也就是说是处在至尊人格首神这一层面的。
So after Lord Chaitanya had been worshipped by Advaita Acharya, then Lord Chaitanya would take the dish with the flowers and the tosi and whatever paraphernalia was left, and he would worship Advaita Acharya.
然后呢，就在啊，对的 ，Acharya 他崇拜过 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 之后呢，然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就会用剩下的所有的这些祭祀的物品，这个盘子呀，还有这个图拉西叶子呀，还有这个檀香香叶，还有就无论还剩下什么，他都用剩下的这个物品呢来崇拜 Advaita Acharya。
And when Lord Chaitanya would worship Advaita Acharya, he had a very special mantra he would chant.
当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在崇拜 Advaita Acharya 的时候呢，他会唱诵一段非常特别的曼陀罗。
The mantra, the meaning of the mantra he chanted was, "Whatever you are, you are." But I offer my respects unto you.
他唱诵的这段曼陀罗的意思就是，无论您是什么，那您就是他。但是呢，我都要向您致以我前进的致意。
And then Lord Chaitanya, when he was doing this, he would also make some sounds within his mouth, and these sounds would make Advaita Acharya laugh.
然后呢，主他就会从他的这个嘴里面发出一些声音，然后这个声音呢就会让 Advaita Acharya 笑，会让 Advaita Acharya 发笑。
So in this way, Advaita Acharya and Lord Chaitanya would offer their respects to each other.
所以就以这样的方式呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Advaita Acharya 他们之间彼此之间相互的致以着敬意。
And then Advaita Acharya would invite Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to come to his house to take prasadam.
然后呢 ，Advaita Acharya 就会邀请 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到他的家中荣耀 prasadam.
And Advaita Acharya, he wanted Lord Chaitanya to come to his house every day to take prasadam.
Advaita Acharya 他希望 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 每天都能够到他家里面去荣耀 prasadam.
There were many devotees in Jagannath Puri, and they also wanted to invite Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya couldn't go to everyone's house for lunch.
但是呢，在 Jagannath Puri 还有很多其他的奉献者，他们也都希望能够邀请 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到他们家里面去荣耀午餐。但是呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他没有办法去到所有的奉献者的家里。
What would happen is that When Lord Chaitanya would agree to come to a devotee's house for lunch, many other devotees would also go, and then there would be a big festival there.
So, this 发生的这个情况就是这样的。当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他答应到其中的一个奉献者家里去荣耀午餐的时候呢，其他的奉献者也会去到那个奉献者的家里，这样大家就好像是在过一个大节一样。
So we said all the devotees came from Bengal, and they came.Just at the beginning of Chaturmasya, they came there for Rath Yatra.
那我们知道，孟加拉的奉献者呢，他们会来到 Jagannath Puri， 但他们来的时候呢，是刚好是 Chaturmasya 四月苦行刚开始的时候，他们来这儿呢是要参加弹车节 Rath Yatra.
And they're going to stay for four months.
然后呢，他们会在 Jagannath Puri 住上四个月的时间。
Because it The Chaturmasya, people don't travel at that time. Usually it's the rainy season, just like here in Mayapur this year, a lot of rain. So when it rains, it's very difficult to travel.There's no proper roads in India usually, and it's very muddy and very difficult to move. So better to just stay in one place.
所以说呢，只要一下雨，在旅行在路上是很难的，因为在印度没有很好的道路，而且呢一下雨呢到处都会特别的泥泞，所以呢就最好还是就待在一个地方别动。
So after the Rath Yatra festival, there's many other festivals you have.Krishna's birthday, Janmashtami, and then you have Nanda Maharaj's festival, Nanda Mahotsav, the day after Janmashtami.
然后呢，就是在这个弹车节之后呢，其实后面紧跟着很多的节日的， 比如说有 Janmashtami 就是 Sri Krishna 的显现日，然后之后第二天呢是 Nanda Mahotsav 是Nanda
Nanda Maharaj, the father of Krishna, he celebrates that his wife has given birth to a son.
Okay, 那么就这个 Nanda Mahotsav 这个节日呢，就是 Nanda Maharaj 他会庆祝他的妻子，诞下了一个儿子的这个节日。
In honor of his wife giving birth, he will give a lot of charity.
所以呢，就是。为了庆祝他的妻子，这个生孩子的这个事情呢，他就会给很多的布施。
And at that time, Lord Chaitanya and the devotees, they all dressed themselves up like cowherd boys.
就在那一天的时候呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和所有的这些奉献者们，全部都会打扮成像是牧牛童的模样。
They put on.Turbans and they had peacock feathers on their heads, and they were all carrying flutes, and they carried ropes for tying the legs of the cows, and they'd have bugles to call the cows.
他们全都会戴上头巾，然后在头巾上插上孔雀羽毛，而且呢，他们也会吹着笛子，然后呢，他们还会就是握着这个绳子，这个绳子就是。赶牛的这个绳子，还会吹着号角，用这个号角来呼唤牛。
And then they carried also pots of yogurt and milk. They would have rods across their shoulder and eat a pot of some either yogurt or milk.
Maharaj.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yes. Yes, now I can hear, but I didn't hear the whole thing what you said earlier.
Yeah, it was unstable, right?Okay, I'll say again. In the villages in India, they put this rod across their shoulder, a piece of wood, a strip of wood, and on either end of the rods, they'd hang a pot. On one side, there'd be a pot of milk, on the other side, a pot of yogurt, or maybe two pots of milk.
就是，然后呢，他们在肩上还会扛着一根棍儿。那么这根棍儿的就像是一个这个扁担一样。然后呢，这个棍的两头呢，会拴着两个罐儿，这两个罐里面呢，要不然就盛着一罐酸奶，一罐牛奶，或者就是两边抬着全部都是牛奶或者都是酸奶。
And so they would all the cowherd boys, all of Lord Chaitanya and his associates, they would all come for the festival, and they'd dress like this and carry the milk and yogurt, and they'd all be chanting the holy name.
所以说呢，就是由水车三娘马法布和他的同游们所装扮成牧牛童的这个样子，都会扛着酸奶和牛奶来参加这个节日，而且呢，他们还会一边唱诵着圣名来参加这个节日。
And one of the devotees was dressed up like Nanda Maharaj, and another devotee dressed like Mother Yashoda.
其中的一位奉献者呢，他会装扮成。Nanda Maharaj 的样子，而另外一位奉献者呢，会装扮成亚修的妈妈的样子。
And the king of Puri, he also came and attended the program, took part in everything.
那么，Puri 的这位国王呢，他也会来参加这个节日，而且呢，他也会让自己全情投入的参加，这每一个部分的内容。
And Lord Chaitanya was dancing and chanting ecstatically.And everybody got covered with the milk and the yogurt and the turmeric water.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他会就会在极乐中歌唱跳舞。所有的人呢，身上全部都被撒满了牛奶、酸奶，还有姜黄粉融化的水。
And so Advaita Acharya said at that time, he said, "Oh, don't get angry."Please tell the truth. I will know if you are a cowherd boy, if you can wheel this rod about. The cowherd boys, they carry these sticks, you see, which they use to herd the cows. And they like tap the cows on the side with the stick. So each of the cowherd boys, they carry these sticks.So what they do is they will throw the stick up in the air and they do different, different behavior with it, you know, and they burrow around and move the rod, make the rod go round in circle.
Yes, yes, yes. 然后当时对特尔查尔他就说，你可别生气，你要知道，如果你要是真的是木牛童的话，那您就能够把这个棍儿这么抡着甩起来，在天空中它这个转起来。就是刚才马尔他也解释了一下，就是他们所有扛的这根棍儿呢，就是木牛童他们用的这根棍儿。然后这个木牛童他们会用这根棍儿呢去赶牛，但与此同时呢，他们还会玩这根棍儿，就是把这个棍儿不断的抛向空中，然后呢让这个棍儿在空中打转转。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard the Dvaita Acharya say this, Lord Chaitanya said, oh yes, no problem.
然后呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到 Dvaita Acharya 怎么一说呢，他说当然没问题。
So they got a big rod for Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya took it in his hand, and he began to wheel it just with holding it with one hand. It would go round and round very fast.
然后呢，他们就给 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 找来了一根很长的根棍儿，然后说，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就把这个棍儿，握在他的一只手里面，然后呢就轻而易举的，耍起了这个棍儿，让这个棍儿在他的手里面转动起来，而且转得非常的快。
And then he threw it up in the air, very high, and when it came down, he caught it and he kept it burling, kept it going around.
然后呢，他就把这个棍儿呢一下子又高高的抛向空中。等这个棍儿从空中掉下来的时候呢，他一下子又抓住了这根棍儿，然后继续在他的手中在不断的转动着。
And sometimes Lord Chaitanya would throw the rod over his head.
那有的时候呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就会把这个棍儿甩到他的头顶。
And sometimes he would throw it behind his back.
那有的时候呢，他又把这个棍儿呢甩向他的背后。
Sometimes the rod would be in front of him.
有的时候呢，这根棍儿又会在他的身前。
Sometimes at his side.
有的时候呢，这根棍儿又在他的身子的旁边。
And sometimes between his legs.
有的时候呢，这根棍儿又会在他的双腿的中间。
So all the devotees were laughing to see Lord Chaitanya do all these things with the rod.
所以呢，当奉献者们看着 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这样。就是如此花哨的在耍这根棍儿的时候呢，所有人都笑了。
Everybody understood. Wow, he's really a cowherd boy.
所有人都能够明白，他真的是一位名副其实的木牛童。
那 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the stake and he whirled it around so fast. Everyone who saw it, they were astonished. Wow.
然后呢，水天天巴巴布他就把这根棍儿在他的手中转起来，然后呢，让这根棍儿转得可快可快了，让所有的奉献者们都非常的惊讶的看着这根转得十分快的棍儿。
And then Lord Nityananda, he also started doing the same thing.
然后朱尼天南达呢，他也开始做同样的事情。
So both Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda were in the mood of the cowherd boys.
所以这会儿呢，水车丹娘妈妈布和主尼天丹达都处于在木牛童的心绪之中。
Then, by the order of the king, one of the men from the temple they brought a beautiful cloth from Lord Jagannath and they gave it to Lord Chaitanya.
这会儿呢，在国王的命令之下呢，一个人就从庙里面拿来了一块用在主 Jagannath 身上的一块布。然后呢，把这块布呢就送给了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
The cloth was wrapped around the head of Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，这块布呢就把它给包裹在了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的头上。
And other devotees like Advaita, they also had cloth put around their heads.
那这会儿呢，其他的奉献者，比如说像 Advaita Acharya 呢，他们也用其他的一些这个布袋，裹在他们的头上。
And the devotee, one devotee, we said he was dressed up like Nanda Maharaj, and there was another devotee dressed like Mother Yashoda. They began to distribute all of their wealth.
然后刚才我们也说到了，其中有一位奉献者呢，他装扮成 Nanda Maharaj 的样子，另外一位奉献者呢是装扮成亚瑟的妈妈的样子，然后他们就开始派发他们所有的财富。
Whatever they had at home, whatever they had in their home, they were distributing, giving it away to other people.
他们把家里边的所有的这些财宝全部都拿出来， 派发给其他的人。
When Lord Chaitanya saw this, he was very happy, and he accepted them as his father and mother.
当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 看到这个景象的时候呢，他感到非常的开心，他也就接受这一对奉献者为他们的为他的父母亲。
Another festival which they celebrated when they're in Jagannath Puri, which came after the Janmashtami, there's a festival which is the day when Lord Ramachandra conquered Ravan when he went to Lanka and defeated the demons in Lanka.
那在 Jagannath Puri, 在 Janmashtami 之后呢，他们还会庆祝另外一个节日。这个节日呢，就是主 Ramachandra, 征服了 Ravana, 从 Lanka 返回之后的那个庆祝日。
So in honor of this festival, Lord Chaitanya had all the devotees dressed up as monkey soldiers.
所以呢，在那个节日的那一天呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就让所有的奉献者们全部都装扮成猴子军队的这个士兵的样子。
And Lord Chaitanya, he took the mood of Hanuman, and he took up a big tree, and he climbed the wall as if he was climbing into the fort.
然后呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他此时处在的是哈努曼的心绪之下，那他就爬上了一棵树，然后呢，就是靠着这棵树爬上那个墙，就好像他是在翻越那个城堡一样。
Yeah, because Lanka was a fort, so they had to climb over the wall. So Lord Chaitanya was in the mood of Hanuman. Hanuman climbing into the Lanka fort.
所以因为 Lanka 它是一座城堡，所以呢要进去就必须要翻越城墙，所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就处在 Hanuman 的这个心绪之下，他要通过翻越城墙才能够翻到 Lanka 城堡里面。
So Lord Chaitanya in the mood of Hanuman, he said, "Where is that rascal Ravana?"
所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在 Hanuman 的心境之下，他就吼问道，那个流氓 Ravana 在哪里？
He's kidnapped the universal mother, Sita. I'm going to kill him and all of his family. Everyone was astonished to see the mood of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So there were many festivals during these 4 months when the devotees were staying there.
所以说呢，当所有的奉献者们在这儿居住的这四个月的时间里面，是有很多的节日的。
Just like one of the festivals is on the day of Rasa Lila, the day in which Krishna danced Rasa Lila with the gopis. It's on a full moon night in that month of Kartik.
那么就像是在卡蒂卡月的时候，在满月之日，所以 Krishna 和 Gopi 姑娘们一起上演的 Rasa 的逍遥时光，就是 Rasa 之舞的逍遥，这也是个节日。
And also Diwali is an important festival that takes place.
还有就是 Diwali 节，那这也是在这段时间之内他们所庆祝的一个节日。
And it takes place also during the month of Kartik.
这也是在卡提克这个月的时候所庆祝的一个节日。
And that, of course, we celebrate Govardhan Puja at that time.
而且对于我们来说呢，在那段时间我们也会庆祝 Govardhan Puja.
And we also have Prabhupada's Srila Prabhupada's disappearance festival during the month of Kartik.
在卡提克月的时候呢，我们也会过庆祝是。
And another day, a festival which Lord Chaitanya observed was called Uttana Dwadasi, which is in the month of Kartik, which after the day after Ekadasi.
It is also in
the day after.
Right?
Yeah.
那就是在这个Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他也要庆祝一个。日子，这个日子呢是在卡提卡月的艾法达西之后的那一天，被称为叫 Uttama Dwardasi.
So Lord Chaitanya, now it's coming, after all the festivals, it comes time for the devotees to go back to Bengal, and Lord Chaitanya meets with all them and he gives them instructions before they go back.
那么在这个四个月结束之后呢，就是迎来了所有的这些奉献者们他们要返回孟加拉的日子了。那么在他们返回孟加拉之前呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢就见了所有的这些奉献者们，和他们道别，并且给他们以训谕。He
requested them. He said, "Please, I want you to come every year to see me here in Jagannath Puri, and come in time to help to clean the temple of the Gundicha temple."
那他对他们是这样请求的，他说：“我希望你们呢，每年都能够来Jagannath Puri，和我一起联谊，在这里面能够见到我，而且我希望你们是能够在这个就是能够一起来打扫Gundicha庙的这个时间来一起来打扫Gundicha庙。”That
means you have to be here at least in time for the Rath Yatra.
也就意味着你们必须。
And ideally, you should be here even for the Snan Yatra, for the bathing of Jagannath.
那这个更好的、更理想的呢，是你们能够来参加 Snan Yatra， 也就是参加为主Jagannath的沐浴仪式。
So Lord Chaitanya said to Advaita Acharya, he said, "I want you to give Krishna consciousness even to the lowest of men, even to the chandalas, the people at the bottom of the society."
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Advaita Acharya 说呢，他说我希望你能够把 Krishna 知觉传递给那些哪怕是处于最低层的人，最底层的人 chandala man， 就是在这个社会阶层中最底层的那些人。
There are different levels of men. On the top you have the brahmanas, and on the bottom are the chandalas.
所以呢，就是作为人呢是有不同的阶层的，在最高的呢是婆罗门，在最低层的就是禅的了。So
in the Kali Yuga, everyone is a fallen soul, and it doesn't matter what position they're in, they need to be enlightened.
但是呢，在卡利年代，因为我们所有的人现在都是堕落的灵魂，所以也就无所谓我们到底处在社会阶层的哪个位置了。所有的人都是需要得到启明，得到点化的。
So the Krishna consciousness movement is helping to save people from all the anxiety and the misery of being in this Kali Yuga.
所以说呢， Krishna 知觉其实就是帮助在卡利年代的人们能够解除他们在卡利年代所经受的痛苦和焦虑。
Krishna, the Krishna consciousness movement can help the whole world to be peaceful and happy.
Krishna 知觉运动，它可以帮助整个世界变得快乐，变得平和。And
even by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, even the chandalas can become peaceful and happy.
而且就在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈之下，就连 chandala 都能够变得平和，变得快乐起来。So
we have to give charity, and the best charity to give people is Krishna consciousness.
所以呢，我们必须要给予布施。那最好的布施呢，就是把 Krishna 知觉给予大众。One
who is giving Krishna consciousness is that he is the most charitable person.
当人把 Krishna 知觉给予别人的时候，也就意味着他是最具有布施心肠的人。Some
people they're doing what seems like bhakti, but they're only doing it to get money. That's not good.
那有些人呢，他看起来好像是在从事bhakti的活动，但他做这个呢，只是为了想要赚钱而已，这个不太好。We
should all become pure devotees and give up all of our material motives.
那我们都应该让自己成为纯粹的奉献者，放弃自己物质的动机。Then
Lord Chaitanya told Nityananda, he said, "Nityananda Prabhu, you go to Bengal and without restriction, give devotional service."
然后呢， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对Nityananda Prabhu 说呢，说Nityananda Prabhu， 我希望你能够去到孟加拉，并且在没有任何设限的情形 没有设限的情况下把Krishna 知觉派发出去。
So Lord Chaitanya wanted Lord Nityananda Prabhu to preach in the Bin and to all the Bengalis and to give them Krishna consciousness.
所以说呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他是希望主尼天丹的帕布在孟加拉传教，然后把这个 Krishna 知觉给予在孟加拉地区的所有人。
Now some people misunderstand Lord Chaitanya's instruction to Lord Nityananda.
但是有些人呢，他就会误解 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给予主尼天丹的训示。
They think that Lord Chaitanya told Lord Nityananda that he should go back to Bengal.And get married and have children.
那他们觉得是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给主尼天南达的训示是要让他回到孟加拉，并且呢在孟加拉结婚生子。
So this is a great offense against Lord Nityananda.
其实这个呢是对主尼天南达的一个巨大的冒犯。
They think Lord Nityananda is just like them. They think he's just an ordinary human being.
因为他们这样想呢，就把 Sri Nityananda Prabhu 给想成了和他们一样的普通人了。
They don't understand Lord Nityananda is Vishnu Tattva.
他们并不理解主尼天南达是处在 Vishnu Tattva 的范畴的。
They think Lord Nityananda is just his body is just material. It's just made of the material elements.
他们觉得朱尼天南达的躯体是物质的，只不过是由物质的元素构成的。
And they think the goal of his Lord Nityananda's life was just sense gratification.
而且呢，他们觉得朱尼天南达的生活的目标就是要进行感官享乐。
So people who think like that, they will go to hell.
所以有这样想法的人，他们是会下地狱的。
If people are lusty and materialistic.Want to enjoy the other sex, then certainly they will. These people are going to go down in the material world.
就是非常的充满了色欲，总是有着这个物质的就物欲心心的人，那他一定是会下行的。然后呢，他会被桎梏在这个物质世界的。
They will simply.Criticize the devotees and criticize the scriptures.
那他们要做的事情呢，就是会批评奉献者，批评经典。
We should understand the identity of Lord Nityananda, that he is the expansion of Lord Chaitanya.
那我们应该了解主尼天南达的身份，主尼天南达是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的扩展。
And he is a very, very merciful personality.
而且呢，朱尼天南达他是一位非常非常仁慈的人物。
So we should never think Lord Nityananda just to be an ordinary person only interested in sense gratification.
那所以说呢，我们可不要认为朱尼天南达他只是一个普通的人，仅仅是想着感官享乐而已。
We don't find in any scripture anywhere that Lord Nityananda is an ordinary person.
我们不会在任何一本经典里，在任何一个地方找到这个信息，说 Sri Nityananda Prabhu 是一个普通人。
Anyway, Lord Chaitanya told him, "You go back to Bengal and preach there." And he gave him many assistants to go with him.
无论如何呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就让朱尼天南达帕布去到孟加拉，并且在那个地方传教，而且呢。他还给他指派了很多的助手和他一起去。
And Lord Chaitanya told them, he said, I will also come there sometimes, I will also come there to see you, but I will keep myself invisible.
然后是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我本人也会时不时的去到孟加拉去看望你，但是呢，我会让自己处在不可被见到的状态。
Right, sometimes Lord Chaitanya...Sometimes Lord Chaitanya is manifest and sometimes he's not.
就是他要处在一个隐身的状态，因为Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他有的时候呢是显现的，有的时候呢他让自己处在不显现的状态。
But Lord Chaitanya said, I want to watch you dance, so sometimes I will come there to see you dance.
但是主持人妈妈会说呢，但是我想看你跳舞，所以有的时候呢，我会去拜望你，并且呢观看你跳舞。
Just like when Lord Nityananda was at Panihati, and they had a big festival, and he paid for everything. Raghunath had given all the money to buy all the boga, and then they had a big kirtan, and they saw Lord Chaitanya appeared there. Although he wasn't there, he appeared in his subtle form.
嗯，那就比如说，嗯，主尼天南的帕布呢，他安排了一个被称为叫帕尼哈提的节日，那么是由 Raghunath Das Goswami， 就 Raghunath Das， 他准备了这个节日相关的所有的这些物品。然后呢，当时 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 其实不是在那个节日现场的，但是呢，他就在那儿了，而且他会在那儿跳舞。
Yeah, but not everybody could see him.
但是呢。并不是当时参加节日的所有人都能够见到水田参加马帕布来参加这个节日了。
He would keep himself invisible.
所以呢，他会让自己处在隐身的状态。
So then Lord Chaitanya spoke to Srivas Pandit.
然后呢，水田参加马帕布呢又对Srivas Pandit 说。
And remember, Lord Chaitanya used to go to the home of Srivas Pandit every evening, spend the whole night there to do kirtan.
我们要记得曾经呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他每天晚上都会去到 Srivas Pandit 的家里面，然后彻夜的在他家里面进行 kirtan。
So Lord Chaitanya told Srivas, he said, continue to do the kirtan every day.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Srivas 说，你要每天继续的在家里面进行 kirtan。
And I will also dance in your presence.
而且呢，我也会在你面前跳舞。
And you will be able to see me dancing, but not others.
而且呢，你也能够见到我跳舞，可是别人见不到。
Then Lord Chaitanya said, I want you to take this prasadam, this Jagannath prasadam, and here this cloth of Jagannath, I want you to take these two things and give them to my mother, Sachi Devi.
然后呢，他又对Srivas说呢，我希望你能够把这个 Jagannath 的 Prasadam 还有这块 Jagannath 围过的布一起带回去，带给我的妈妈 Sachi Devi。
And ask my mother to forgive me for all my offenses.
并且呢，请求我的妈妈能够原谅我所有的冒犯。
I have given up the service of my mother by taking sannyas. I've had to give up the service of my mother.
那我因为让自己成为了一名散压西，所以呢，我就只能放弃对我母亲的服务。
I shouldn't have done that.
我本不应该这么做的。
By taking sannyas, I've destroyed my religious principles.
所以说呢，我因为让自己成为了散压西，从而使我自己破坏了我的。宗教原则。
Right, according to religious principles, the son is duty bound to serve the mother, but he took sannyas, he had to leave the home.
因为作为一个儿子，他所应该奉行的宗教原则就是他应该是去服务伺候他的母亲的。但是呢，由于他自己让自己成为了sannyasi，所以他就只能离开家了。
So Lord Chaitanya said, my duty.Is to serve my mother.
所以呢，释迦牟尼佛说呢，我的职责本应该是服我的母亲。
And she gave me so much love when I was a child.
因为当我是孩子的时候，她那么的爱我。
But instead, I have become a sannyasi. Certainly, I'm like a madman.
所以我没有伺候她，反而我让自己成为了一名sannyasi，我就像是一个疯子一样。
But my mother is, she's, although I'm a mad person, my mother has not been offended by me.
但是虽然说我行为举止有如疯子一般，但是我的妈妈呢，却没有被却不认为我冒犯了她。
And I'm sure Sachi Mata is not offended by me.
我敢肯定 Satchimata 没有被我所冒犯。
Lord Chaitanya said, I sacrificed my love for my mother, which was my real property.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我牺牲了我的母亲对我的爱，那么这个其实是我真正的财产。
So now I'm staying at Jagannath Puri. Under her, that was her order that I should come and stay at Jagannath Puri. That's why I'm here.
而现在呢，我是让自己定居在 Jagannath Puri. 那这也是我的母亲对我的训令。那我是在她的训令之下，所以我才住在这里。
But regularly I go to see her. I go to visit her home.
但其实我是经常会去拜望她的。我经常到他的家里去看望他。
I go daily to see her lotus feet.
我每天都去参拜他的莲花足。
And she can feel my presence, but she doesn't know if it's true or not.
他其实是能够感受到我的临在的，但是他不知道到底是真，他这个感受是否真实。
So Lord Chaitanya began to describe to tell Advaita how he would go to the home of Mother Sachi.
所以说呢，朱彻坦尼玛巴布呢，他就开始描述着他是怎么回萨奇妈妈的家的。
So Lord Chaitanya described, he said, one day my mother cooked food to offer to the Shaligram Shila.
然后他就说呢，有一天呢，我的妈妈她就烹饪了食物，然后呢，把这个食物供奉给了 Shaligram Shila。
So she cooked rice, and then she offered various kinds of vegetables, and spinach, and curry.
她呢就是做了米饭，而且呢还做了几道蔬菜，还做了菠菜，还有咖喱。
Made of banana flowers.
然后她还
curry made of banana flowers.Curry made of banana flowers.
他做了这个 curry. 这个 curry 呢是用香蕉花做的。What is curry?
Curry, it's a, well, it's like a soupy, spicy liquid which is served with all the vegetables.
Okay. 我刚才说的是咖喱，不对啊，不是咖喱，就是说是实际上是一种这个。汤水的蔬菜就是蔬菜的这个菜肴，然后是用香蕉花制成的这道菜叫 curry。
And then there was also Lord Chaitanya said there was patola, which was fried with neem leaves.
然后呢，还有一种菜呢叫 patoba， 这个 patoba 呢是用 neem 的树叶炸制的。
And there were pieces of ginger with lemon.
里面呢还放了一片一片的姜和柠檬。
And there was yogurt and milk and sugar.
还有牛奶、酸奶，还里面还放了糖。
Many other foods.
还有很多其他的菜肴。
So Mother Sach, I saw Lord Chaitanya say, I saw my mother. She was crying to think that all this food was being served.To her son, to me, to Nimai.
然后呢，朱彻坦尼玛巴布说，我就看到我的母亲泪流满面的想着，把所有的这些食物都供奉给了他的儿子尼麦。
She prepared all his favorite dishes, but she thought, my son Nimai is not here. Who will take all this food? Who will accept it?
妈妈当时就在想，你看我做了这么多好吃的。但是呢，我的儿子尼麦他就不在，那谁会吃掉所有的这些好吃的饭菜呢
？So she was meditating on Lord Chaitanya, and her eyes were filled with tears.
所以呢，萨奇妈妈她就在冥想着朱彻坦尼玛，眼睛里面满含着泪水。
And Lord Chaitanya said, while she was thinking and crying, then I went there and I ate everything and.I cleaned the dish. It was all empty.
然后是这坦尼玛巴布说，就当他满含泪水的想我的时候呢，那会儿我就去了，我就吃掉了所有的这些饭菜，我把这个我把每一盘菜都吃得干干净净的。
So when she began, mother said she began to wonder who had eaten all the food. How is the plate empty?
How is the plate empty?
所以这会儿呢，萨吉妈妈就感到很奇怪，很困惑，是谁吃了所有的这些饭菜吗？是谁把这些饭菜都给吃得干干净净的呢
？And she thought that maybe the Balagopal deity had eaten it all. She had the deity of Balagopal, so she thought Balagopal must have eaten it all.
因为萨吉妈妈她在崇拜着巴拉戈帕神像，所以呢，她在想，也许可能是巴拉戈帕神像把所有的这些饭菜都给吃掉了。
Or she thought, maybe I never put anything on the plate. Maybe the plate was empty all the time.
然后妈妈又在想，也许可能我根本就没有做过饭，所以说呢，这个盘子里面本来就是空的。
And then she thought, well, wait a minute. Maybe some animal came and ate everything.
然后她又在想，哎，等等，也许要不然就是些什么动物来了，然后这个动物就把所有的这些饭菜都给吃了。
And then she thought, maybe I didn't put any food on the plate. Let me go into the kitchen and see the pots.
然后她又在想，也许可能我根本就没有把饭菜装在盘子里，要不然让我到厨房里面再看看这锅里边到底是怎么回事。
And she went and she saw all the pots were still full with rice and vegetables.
然后呢，她就发现，厨房里面的这个锅里面的这个饭菜还是满着的。里面就是所有的这些这个菜肴都还在。
So she has, mother said she has a servant in the house. The servant's name is Ishan. And so she called him to come.
Yeah, Sachin 妈妈在家里面有一个仆人，这位仆人的名字呢是 Ishan。所以呢，亚瑟的妈妈就唤来了他的仆人。
And so when Ishan came, she had the plate cleaned.And then she offered another plate to Gopal.
So, when the 医生来了之后呢，他就请医生把所有的盘子都给洗干净。之后呢，他又给这个盘子又装满了饭菜来供奉给 Gopal.
Now, whenever mother said she would prepare some good food and she wanted to feed it to me, she would just cry in her anxiety, and I would come.
所以说呢，每次亚瑟的这个萨吉妈妈她做了一些好吃的，她都会哭着想着让我来吃，所以这会儿呢，我就会来。
So mother said she could understand all these things internally, but externally she didn't accept them.
实际上，从内心中来讲，从内在上来讲呢。萨奇妈妈她是明白所有这一切的，但是从外在来说呢，她又不能接受。
So then Lord Chaitanya said, "You ask her just about the last time when you did the festival for Lord Rama defeating Ravana. It's called the Vijay Dashami Day. There was a big festival that day."
Vijay Dashami.就是然后呢水柴丹妮妈妈就说你问亚瑟萨奇妈妈就在那天当我们在过这个Vijay Dashami 的这个节日的时候那个就是主 Ramachandra 他击败了 Ravana 之后所庆祝的那个节日
And when you tell her about this how I came there then she will believe that I really do go there
然后呢？当你在跟他这么说的时候，并且你跟他说我去了他那里，然后呢，萨奇妈妈她就能够相信我肯定是去过了。
So then Lord Chaitanya spoke to Raghava Pandit, and he said, told Raghava Pandit, "I'm obliged to you due to your pure love for me."
然后呢，所以 Chaitanya 妈妈不就对 Raghava Pandit 说。说我非常的亏欠于你所对我展现的纯粹之爱。
So Raghava Pandit would do very incredible devotional service.
因为 Raghava Pandit 为 Sri Chaitanya 他所做出来的这个奉献服务是非常的令人惊叹、不可思议的。
His home is at Panihati,
他的家呢是帕尼哈提。
And Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, sometimes they would go there, and they would go there to enjoy the food which they would be cooking there.
就是他的家在帕尼哈提，有的时候呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和主尼天丹的就会到帕尼哈提这个地方，然后呢去享受他们所在那里烹制的食物。
Raghava Pandit had a sister called Damayanti, and they would cook for Lord Chaitanya.And they would cook the whole year, and then when they would come to Jagannath Puri, they would bring everything they cooked, and somehow everything would still be fresh.
Raghava Pandit 有一位姐妹，名字是 Damayanti， 然后呢，他们在家里面就一整年都会为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 做好吃的，然后呢，他们来到 Jagannath Puri 的时候呢，就会把这些好吃的给带来。就是不知道什么原因，就是这一整年烹制的这个食物依然还会非常的新鲜。
So, and also it said that one of the places where Lord Chaitanya dances is at the home of Raghava Pandit.
有这样一个说法，就是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他跳舞的其中有一个地方就是 Raghava Pandit 的家。
So,In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it tells about how he would offer coconuts to his deities.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 里面就讲了 Raghava Pandit 他如何把椰子供奉给他的神像。
So Raghava Pandit had hundreds of trees, and if each tree had many coconut fruits.
Raghava Pandit 他种了好多好多的树。每一棵树上呢都结满了叶子。
But Raghava Pandit wanted coconuts which were the best. He wanted they had to be very sweet, otherwise he wouldn't like to offer them to the deities.
但是呢 ，Raghava Pandit 他必须呢要把这个最棒的叶子，就是最甜的叶子，把它供奉给神像，否则的话他是不会把这个叶子供奉给神像的。
And he was so careful, he would go far, he would go even 20 miles away just to find good coconuts. So every day, 5 to 7 coconuts would be cut down and they would be put into water to keep cool.
每天呢都会砍下五到 5 to 7 每天呢他都会砍下5到7只椰子，然后呢把这个椰子呢放到水里面浸着，让这个椰子一直保持着清凉。
So at the time of offering the coconuts, just before they're offered, the coconuts are cleaned and clipped, and they make a hole in them.In the top, so that Lord Krishna can drink.
所以呢，在要供奉椰子之前呢，然后他就先把这个椰子给洗干净了，然后呢，在椰子的上面打一个洞，然后这样呢，就能使 Sri Krishna 就能够喝到里面的椰汁了。
So sometimes Lord Krishna would drink the juice from these coconuts, and sometimes the coconuts are, after they're offered, they come off the altar. There's no water left in them anymore.
所以说有的时候呢 Sri Krishna 他就会喝这个椰汁，那么就当他们把这个椰子从神坛上给撤下来，这个供奉给撤下来的时候，就发现这椰汁已经没有了，这椰子里面已经没有任何的汁水了。
Sometimes the coconuts are still got water, not every time, but Lord Krishna sometimes he will drink all the water.
但是有的时候呢这个椰子里面的椰汁还在，就是 Sri Krishna 他有的时候是会把椰子里面的水全都给喝了的。
So when Raghava Pandit would see that all the water had been drunk from the coconut, he'd feel very happy.
所以说呢，当 Raghava Pandit 看到这椰子里面的汁液全部给喝掉了之后呢，他就感到特别的开心。
So then what he would do is he would break the coconuts and take out the coconut pulp and put it on another plate.
然后呢，他就会切开这个椰子，然后把里面的这个椰肉全都给挖出来，然后把这个椰肉呢放到另外一个盘子里。
And then he would meditate outside the temple on offering the pulp to Krishna.
然后呢，他就会在庙的外面来冥想，冥想着把椰肉奉奉给 Krishna。
And Lord Krishna would eat the pulp, and the plate would be empty.
这样呢，主 Krishna 他也会把这椰肉给吃掉，这个盘子又空了。
And sometimes Krishna would put new pulp on the plate. After he'd eaten the old pulp, he would put another pulp on the plate.
有的时候呢 ，Krishna 在吃完了这些椰肉之后呢，他会把新的椰肉再重新放回到盘子里。
So in this way, Raghava Pandit was feeling so much ecstasy and love for Krishna when he saw all this happening.
所以呢，当 Raghava Pandit 看到所有这些事情发生的时候呢，他就会处在极乐之中，处在对 Krishna 的极乐之爱里。
So one day it happened that there were 10 coconuts prepared and brought by a servant. They were brought to the deities to be offered to the deity.
那有一天呢，他们就准备了十只椰子，然后这十只椰子都被仆人收拾好了以后呢，就把它送到了这个神像的面前。
So when the coconuts were brought, the offering was a little bit late, and they were rushing.
但是呢，当他们把这个椰子准备好的时候呢，这会儿这个供奉的时间已经有点晚了，所以呢，大家有点着急。
So the servant was holding the container of coconuts. He was standing at the door.
那这个仆人呢，他就拿着拖着这个椰子的这个器皿，然后站在门口。
But then Raghava Pandit saw that the servant touched the ceiling above the door, and then he touched the coconuts with the same hand.
但是呢 ，Raghava Pandit 他这会就看到了这个仆人，他用手碰了这个庙门的顶部，然后呢，用这同一只这只手又碰了椰子。
So Raghava Pandit thought.We know people are always coming and going through this door.
然后 Raghava Pandit 就在想，因为我们知道，就这个门经常会有人来人往的从这穿过。
And the dust from their feet blows up, and it goes on the ceiling.
而且呢，就是过来过往的这个人脚上的这个尘土呢，就会扬起来，并且呢，会粘在门顶上。
And that servant had just touched the ceiling. He touched the ceiling, and then he touched the coconuts.
可是呢，这个仆人刚才就又碰了这个门的顶部，然后呢，他又用他的手，同一只手又碰了椰子。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "Now these coconuts, Raghava Pandit said, now these coconuts cannot be offered to Krishna because they are contaminated."
所以说呢 ，Raghava Pandit 就在想，他就在想，那现在这些椰子都脏了，所以呢，椰子不能够再供奉给 Krishna 了。
So you hearing this, you may think this Raghava Pandit must be a crazy man. Hearing this, you may think Raghava Pandit is a crazy person.
Sorry, Marge, I was off.And I am come back again.
Oh, okay. So Raghava, when we hear this pastime about Raghava Pandit, we may think he's a crazy person. He has a phobia about cleaning.
那所以说呢，就当我们听到 Raghava Pandit 的这个消失光的时候呢，我们可能就会在想 ，Raghava Pandit 他是个疯子，他有洁癖。
Yeah, because the servant touched the ceiling and then he touched the coconuts.
因为呢，这个仆人他用手碰了门的顶部，然后呢又碰了椰子。
So Raghava Pandit said, "Cannot offer these coconuts anymore."
那所以 Raghava Pandit 就想，那所有的这些椰子都不能再供奉了。
So we have to understand Raghava Pandit is an eternal devotee. He's a liberated soul from the spiritual world.
那我们要知道 Raghava Pandit 他是来自于灵性世界的永恒解脱了的灵魂。
And everything he saw was related to Krishna's service.
那么他所见到的所有的一切呢，都是和 Sri Krishna 的服务相连接在一起的。
And he was always thinking about how he could serve Krishna.
而且呢，他脑子里时刻都在想着怎么能够更好的服务 Sri Krishna。
But we cannot imitate such a devotee。
但是呢，我们是不能够去模仿这样的奉献者的。
But we can appreciate his wonderful qualities。
但是呢，我们可以去欣赏、赞美他如此美妙的品质。
We should understand.On the transcendental platform, there's nobody higher and nobody lower, and there's nothing pure and there's nothing impure.
其实我们应该知道，从超人的层面上来讲呢，没有谁比谁更高或更低，而且呢，也没有什么是不纯净的或什么是纯净的。
But in the material world, we see there's.We're always thinking, this is good, this is bad. I like this, I don't like that.
但是呢，在这个物质世界里面，我们就会有这样一个想法，就是这是好的，这是不好的，我喜欢它，我不喜欢它。
So, the service of Raghava Pandit is very special.
所以说呢，Raghava Pandit的服务是非常特别的。
So when the servant touched the coconuts after touching the ceiling, then he had all those coconuts thrown away.
那所以说呢，就是当 Raghava Pandit 的这个仆人，他因为这个触碰了门顶，然后又触碰了椰子，这样呢，就使得他要把所有的这些椰子都给扔了。
Yeah.Haribo?
Yes, Maharaj.
Okay.、
I have already translated what you said just now.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So then Raghava Pandit got some more coconuts and he had them. He had them all cut and cleaned and then he offered them to the deities.
然后呢 Raghava Pandit 又安排了一些其他的椰子让这些椰子都被洗干净了之后被切开了之后呢然后再重新的供奉给主。
And not only would he offer coconuts like this, he would do the same with other things like bananas and mangoes and oranges.
那他不仅仅是以这样的方式在供奉椰子，那其他的，比如说像芒果呀，像橘子呀，还有像香蕉呀，所有的这些东西他在供奉的时候都是这样的标准。
Whenever he would hear that there's some very nice fruits, then he would want to purchase some and offer them to the deities.
只要他听说什么地方有新鲜的水果，他都会立刻去把这个水果买来，然后把这水果供奉给神像。
And he'd bring fruits from a faraway place, and he'd buy them at expensive prices.
他呢会到很远的地方去，花重金买这些水果。
And Raghava Pandit would offer everything to the deities.
然后呢 ，Raghava Pandit 他会把所有的这一切都供奉给神像。
And he would prepare nice preparations for Lord Chaitanya, things like spinach and radishes and fruit, chipped rice.
然后呢，他如果看见的还会为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 准备非常精美的餐食，比如说像是那个红菜头，还有像菠菜，还有碎米饭。
And cakes and sweet rice and condensed milk.
还有糕点、甜米饭，这个甜奶饭和就是非常稠的奶制品。
And he would do the cooking with great attention, and everything would be prepared so perfectly. It would be very delicious.
那他们在做饭的时候呢，是非常的专注的。所有的每一道菜都是非常的鲜美精致的。
He would have many different kinds of pickles to offer also.
在很多时候呢他也会供奉咸菜。
And he would have different perfumes and garments and ornaments.
他也会献上各种各样的香水花环还有饰品。
In this way, Raghava Pandit would do incredible service to Krishna.
所以就是这样的方式呢 Rawa Pandit 向 Sri Krishna 献上令人惊叹的服务。
So Lord Chaitanya embraced him and offered all the devotees, all the other devotees, he offered them also the similar respect.
Okay, 然后呢，所以扎丹尼亚巴巴布呢就会拥抱 Raghava Pandit， 并且呢也向所有的其他的奉献者们也献上同样的敬意。
So the devotees had come there with Shivananda Sen. He was like the leader, and he would pay everything. He would arrange for all the fares, and if they have to go on a boat, whatever. And he knew the paths. He'd tell them which way to go.
所有的这些奉献者们，孟加拉的这些奉献者们都是和希万丹达信一起来的。希万丹达信呢，他就像是所有的这些奉献者们的领导一样，他组织奉献者们前来，然后呢，他也是为所有的这些费用买单的那个人。而且他也知道这个路线是什么样子的，他也会安排船只。
So Lord Chaitanya told Shivananda Sen, he said, "Please take care of Vasudev Datta."
所以水车丹娘妈妈就对施文丹的信说呢，请你一定要照顾好 Vasudev Datta。
Vasudev Datta is so kind hearted that whatever income he gets every day he will spend it all, he doesn't keep any money。
Vasudev Datta 他有着如此慈悲的心肠，他每天所赚得的钱呢，他都会把它给花掉，他一点也不会存下来。
But Vasudev Datta is a householder, he should have some money。
但是 Vasudev Datta 他是一位居士，他是应该留一点钱的。
So because he doesn't keep any money, it's very difficult for him to maintain his family.
但就是因为他一点钱都不给自己留，所以呢，他养家还挺难。
So please, please take care of Vasudev Datta's family affairs.
那所以呢，请你一定要照顾好 Vasudev Datta 的家庭事务。
Become his manager.And make arrangements so that he can pay everything.
那所以说呢，你要就是成为一个管理者，然后呢把一切都做好安排，所以呢就使得他能够有钱支付所有的账单。
And then he told Shivananda saying, "Come every year and bring all my devotees with you for the Gundicha festival."
然后呢，他又对释迦丹的心说呢：“你每年都要来，都要带着所有的奉献者们来这儿参加贡地彻的庙，贡地彻的节日。”
And Lord Chaitanya said, "I request you to please take care of all of them."
然后呢，释迦丹娘妈妈说呢：“我请求你一定要照顾好所有的这些奉献者们。”
So you can see the devotee care. Lord Chaitanya was very concerned for the welfare of the devotees. Each devotee, Lord Chaitanya would be taking care of them and make arrangements for that devotee. If he couldn't take care of that devotee himself, he'd ask someone else to take care of him.
那所以我们在这里面可以看到奉献者关爱。所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他是非常的关注奉献者的关爱的。那么虽然说他自己不能够亲力亲为的去照顾所有的这些奉献者，但是呢，他会委托其他的奉献者好好的照顾其他的奉献者们。
So then Lord Chaitanya would meet with the people from the different villages, and there was one, the devotees from one village, they were to bring the silk ropes every year to carry Lord Jagannath.
然后呢，所以查坦尼亚巴巴布呢，他就会接见来自于各个村落的这些奉献者们。那么其中有一个村子的这个奉献者呢，他们就会为这个 Jagannath 的那个神像拖拽的那根绳子来提供这个绳子，就这个丝绳是由他们来提供的。
So there was this one village from which the devotees had come, and Lord Chaitanya said, "I remember," he said.There was one great devotee from your village in the past, and he wrote a very important book.
然后呢，水车丹娘妈妈又对一个村子里面的奉献者说呢，说我记得就是你们村子里面曾经有一位非常伟大的奉献者，他之前来过这儿，然后呢，他写过一部很重要的书籍。
That book was called Krishna Vijaya. And by reading that book, one can awaken love for Krishna.
就通过阅读这本书，人对于 Krishna 的爱就能够被唤醒。
And the book is written in a very simple language that even uneducated people they can understand it.
而且这本书它的行文呢是非常的简单易懂的，哪怕就是没有受过教育的人也能够读懂这本书的意思。
So Lord Chaitanya said, just listen to this sentence. And Lord Chaitanya read the sentence. He said, Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj, is my life and soul.
然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说，你就听听这句话。然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就开始说这句话，说 Krishna, Nanda Maharaj 的爱儿是我的生命与灵魂。
So Lord Chaitanya said,Because this man has said like this, he said, I have become his property. He's purchased me.
那所以是柴丹加妈妈就说呢，就是因为他这样说了，所以说呢，他就他就把我给购买了。Sorry, Maharaj, could you say it again? Yeah, he purchased me and I become...
His property, I've become his property.
对，然后他就说呢，就是我就被他给购买了，我就成为了他的，这个，我就成为了他的财产。
And Lord Chaitanya said, even dogs living in your village are very dear to me.
然后是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说，就是在你们村子里面的那些狗，对我来说，我都是非常的爱戴的。
So then, a couple of devotees came to Lord Chaitanya, and they wanted to put, they had some questions for Lord Chaitanya. And they said, we are householders, and we are materialistic people, so I don't know how to advance in spiritual life.
然后这会儿呢，有两个奉献者就来到Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的面前，然后呢，想向Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu问问题。他们的问题就是，我们是居士，我们是物质主义者，我们不知道怎么才能够提升我们的灵性生活的进步。
So we put ourselves under your lotus feet, and we request you, please give us some instructions.
所以呢，我们把自己置身在您的莲花足下，我们向您请求能够给我们一些训谕。
So Lord Chaitanya replied, he said, without stopping, you must continuously chant the holy name of Lord Krishna.
所以Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu就对他们说，你们就应该恒常不断的、不间断的唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名。
Whenever possible, you must serve Krishna and serve his devotees, the Vaishnavas.
在任何有可能的情况下，你都应该去服务主 Krishna 以及 Krishna 的奉献者。
So when they heard this, one of them said, "How can I recognize a Vaishnava?"
那当他们听到是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这么一说以后呢，他们就会说，那我们怎么才能够知道谁是 Vaishnava 呢？
Please tell me what is a Vaishnava and what are his symptoms?
所以请您告诉我什么样的人他才是 Vaishnava 以及他所展现出来的真相是什么样呢？
So Lord Chaitanya said, anyone who chants the holy name of Krishna just once is worshipable and is the topmost human being.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，任何一个哪怕仅是念诵了一次 Sri Krishna 的圣名的人，那么他都是一位奉献者，而且呢，他是最顶级的人类。
Right, a person who chants the holy name of Krishna once becomes perfect and should be considered a Vaishnava.
那任何一个哪怕念诵了圣名主 Sri Krishna 的圣名的一次的人，他都会变得完美，并且呢。他被认为是一位 Vaishnava.
So this is something similar to what's said in the Upadeshamrita, the nectar of instruction.
所以呢，这个和在 Upadeshamrita, 也就是教会的甘露中所说的话很类似。
In the fifth verse of the Upadeshamrita, it says, "Krishna te yasya giritam manasadriyeta." that one should mentally honor a devotee who chants the holy name of Lord Hari.
那这个是在教会的纲录的第五个十节里面讲的，就是一个人他应该在内心中向唱了主哈瑞的圣名一次的人致以敬意。
So in the beginning, we have to have some faith in the chanting of the holy name.
所以在最开始的时候呢，我们就应该对唱圣名有一些信心。
An ordinary person cannot chant the holy name with that kind of faith.
那么一个普通的人，他是不可能以那样的信心去念诵圣名的。
We have to understand the holy name of Krishna is not different from Krishna himself.
那我们必须要了解，圣名与 Krishna 本人是没有任何区别的。
The holy name of Krishna is Chintamani.It's a touchstone, it can fulfill all of our spiritual desires.
主克什的圣名是 Chintamani, 是点金石，它可以满足我们所有的愿望。
And the holy name of Krishna is transcendental, it's eternally liberated from material contamination.
而且呢，这个 Krishna 的圣名呢，它是超然的，它是永远的。
One devotee was giving a lecture. He was a sannyasi, and he was giving a lecture in front of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada had asked him to speak about the chanting of the holy name.
有一位奉献者，这位奉献者呢是 sannyasi. 那么 Srila Prabhupada 呢就请让他给大家讲课。讲课的题目呢就是关于唱诵圣名的话题。
So the devotee said, Krishna is in his name. But Prabhupada stopped him and said, no. He said, not that Krishna is in his name. He said, Krishna is his name.
那当时这位神仙喜他在讲课的时候，他就说 Krishna 在他的名字里。然后说到爸爸就阻止了他说，不， Krishna 不是在他的名字里，而 Krishna 就是他的圣名。
So we have to understand that Krishna and Krishna's name are identical.
所以呢，我们就要通过这样去明白 Krishna 和他的名字是没有区别的。
We should chant with that kind of faith.
所以呢，我们应该以那样的信心去念诵 Krishna 的圣名。
So when we're new, when we're neophytes, we can't understand really the nature of pure devotion.
但是呢，当我们非常新，当我们还是初级的奉献者的时候，我们其实是没有办法真正的理解纯粹的奉盖的本性的。
But when we engage in devotional service, especially in the deity worship, and follow the orders of the spiritual master, then you become becomes pure devotion.
但是呢，就是当我们开始纯粹开始，当我们开始进行父爱服务，特别是在灵性导师的训练之下进行神像服务的时候，那会儿它就变成了一种纯粹的奉爱。
So anybody can hear about Krishna consciousness.
任何一个人都可以去听关于 Krishna 知觉的信息。
And but just by hearing, gradually become purified.
那么就通过聆听呢，它就逐渐地变得被净化了。
But if a devotee believes that the holy name of Krishna is the same as Krishna himself, is the same as Krishna, then even though he may be in a neophyte stage, he can be a very advanced devotee.
但是如果一位奉献者他要是相信 Krishna 和他的圣名是完全一样的，没有区别的话，那即便这个奉献者他是处于这个初级的阶段，那么他也是Master, then he is also in the liberated state, right?
Then he is a pure devotee.
然后就即便是他是初级阶段，那他也已经是一位纯粹的奉献者了。
Even though he's a neophyte devotee, he's actually a pure soul, and he can by his association, he can make others devotees.
而且呢，就是即便是他是处在初级阶段的奉献者，但是呢，他有这样的信心，那他就是一位纯粹的灵魂，而且呢，他也可以使其他的人也能够成为奉献者。
So somebody may be a materialistic devotee because he just simply worships a deity with faith, but he doesn't show respect to the devotees.
但是有些人呢，他可能是一个物质主义的奉献者，那他呢是会从事神像崇拜的这个服务，他会对神像展示他的敬意，但是呢，他不会去尊敬其他的奉献者们。
So by associating with a neophyte devotee, one can become a devotee. You can also become a devotee.
但是呢，和一个初级的奉献者联谊，也能够使人成为奉献者。
Lord Chaitanya told this to Sanatana Goswami.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu,
He said, anybody who has got some faith in Krishna consciousness, then he is a good candidate to advance in Krishna consciousness.
他说呢，任何一个对 Krishna 知觉具有一点信心的人，那么他都成为了一个能够在 Krishna 知觉中取得进步的候选人。
So there's first class faith, second class faith, and third class faith. The third class faith is like for the neophyte devotees.
那所以说呢，有一流的信心、二流的信心和三流的信心。那么这个三流的信心呢，也就指的是初级的奉献者所具有的信心。
So that neophyte devotee, he is like the kanista adhikari. He's like materialistic devotee.
那这个初级的奉献者呢，他是 Kanishtha Adhikari 的奉献者，也就是说呢，他是一个物质主义的奉献者。
But he can become an advanced devotee if he follows the principles.
但是如果他要是遵循原则的话呢，他就有可能成为一个高级的奉献者。
He has to follow the principles given by his guru.
但是呢，他必须要遵循他的 guru 所给予他的原则。
So we make advancement.On the basis of two things, faith and attachment to Krishna.
那所以说呢，我们是基于两点让自己取得进步的。第一点呢，就是有信心；第二点呢，就是对 Krishna 的依恋。
From these two things, two qualities, you can understand who is a kanista, who is a madhyam, and who is uttama. Who is the third class, who is second class, and who is first class.
那么就是通过这两点的原则呢，我们就能够看出谁是属于 Kanishtha 初级的状态，谁是属于 Madhyam 就是 中级的状态，二级的状态，谁是属于 Uttama 就是属于最高级的状态的奉献者。
So even though one may be a neophyte devotee, he is still better than any Karmi or any Jnani.
但是呢，如果一个人他哪怕是处在初级奉献者的阶段，但是他也好过任何的一位卡米和加尼。
He is better than these karmis and jnanis because he has faith in the chanting of the holy name.
他之所以比这个卡米和加尼思辨者要好的原因呢，是由于他对于念诵圣名是有信心的。
The karmi or the jnani, they may be great materially, but they have no faith in the holy name. They have no faith in the Lord.
但是就是这个卡米和加尼，他们也许可能在物质上是取得了很大的成功的，但是呢，他们对圣名、对主却没有信心。
They may be advanced in material religion, but they're not trained in devotional service.
他们可能在这个物质的宗教原则中，他们可能是非常的成功的，但是呢，他们却没有受到在奉爱服务的训练。
So they have very little progress on the transcendental platform.
那如果这样说呢，他们在这个超然的层面上来讲，就是举步维艰的，是没有办法往前进的。
That somebody else may be a neophyte devotee, but they're doing deity worship, they're following the rules and regulations.
但是呢，有一些奉献者，他虽然他是初级的奉献者，但是呢，他会进行这个对神像崇拜的服务，然后呢，他们也会遵循规范原则。
So he's much better off than any Karmi or Jnani.
所以说呢，处在这样状态的这个初级奉献者要大大的好过任何的卡米和加利。
Okay. Do we have any questions?
No, we don't have any questions for now.
Okay. So then Lord Chaitanya is describing here, because the devotees asked him how we could advance, right?
Oh, now we have a question.
Okay.
所以呢，因为这个水车他这个奉献者在询问水车他娘妈妈不怎么能够取得进步。
Okay, what's the question?
The question from Yunna, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada said that we are not afraid of Maya enough. Does Maya herself want to mislead us, or does she do it only at our will? Thank you so much for your mercy.云娜的问题是 ：Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 请接受我谦卑的顶拜，所有的荣耀都归于 Srila Prabhupada。 Srila Prabhupada 说呢，我们还不够害怕 Maya。 那么 Maya 他本人是想要误导我们呢，还是他只是在我们的意愿下在做事情？非常感谢您，感谢您的仁慈。
So Maya has a duty.On behalf of Krishna, to test us, to see how sincere we are to engage in Krishna's service.
那 Maya 呢，它其实是代表 Krishna 在履行职责，它要给我们一些试炼，要看看我们到底有多认真的在修习我们的 Krishna 之觉。
Yeah. Maya is...She doesn't want us to go back to Krishna if we're going to create a disturbance there.
Maya, 她其实不想让我们，在还没有准备好的时候回到 Krishna 那儿，因为如果我们要是没准备好就回去的话，那会儿我们就会在那儿捣乱。
So Maya has that's her duty to Krishna to test us to see how genuine we are in our devotional service.
所以说呢。Maya 她的责任就是要来这个考验我们，看我们对于我们的奉爱服务是多么的真诚。
So there's two aspects of Maya. There is the Yoga Maya and there is Maha Maya.
Maya 呢有两个方面，一个是 Yoga Maya， 还有另外一个呢是 Maha Maya。
So Maha Maya covers up Krishna for the ordinary people.And they look at Krishna and they see Krishna as being an ordinary person like them.
Mahamaya 呢，它其实是，把 Krishna 从，普通人的眼睛给，眼前给遮住了。所以呢，普通人当他看到 Krishna 的时候呢，就觉得 Krishna 是个普通人，就像我们自己一样的一个普通人。
So Maya covers up Krishna to reveal him like an ordinary person.
那所以 Maya 呢，他就把 Krishna 给遮盖起来，让 Krishna 展现为就好像是一个普通人一样。
So we look at Krishna and we think, oh, Krishna is like us. He's just an ordinary person.
那所以说呢，当我们看 Krishna 的时候，我们就会说啊 ，Krishna 就不过是一个普通人，他就和我们一样。
Krishna's lusty. Krishna's greedy. Krishna's naughty. He does so many bad things.
那 Krishna 他非常的贪婪。他非常的充满了色欲，他又那么的淘气，他干了好多坏事。
So you know, I have faults, I have problems. You know, I'm just like Krishna.
所以说呢，你看我有一些麻烦，那我有一些，我也出了一些错误，那我就跟 Krishna 一样呗。
So we don't understand Krishna's pastimes. We don't understand the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna's pastimes.
那所以说呢，我们其实是不理解 Krishna 的逍遥时光的，我们没有真正的理解 Krishna。
But when Yoga Maya acts in a different way. Yoga Maya. Yoga Maya acts. Yeah. What happened?
No, there was a break just now.
Okay.
But now I think it's okay.
Yoga Maya acts in a different way. Yoga Maya covers up Krishna.So that we will think of Krishna in one of the rasas which the devotees have with Krishna.
但是 Yoga Maya 它的运作方式是不一样的。 Yoga Maya 呢，它把 Krishna 给这个遮盖起来以后呢，就会让我们觉得 Krishna 是和我们处在某一种 Rasa 的情怀之下在进行着呼应。
Just like Mother Yashoda, she can only think of Krishna as being her child. Even when she's holding up the Govardhan Hill, she thinks, oh Krishna, I don't think he could do it on my own. I think it must have beenMy husband who was holding up the Govardhan Hill.
那就比如说像亚修的妈妈，那她呢把 Krishna 就看成是她自己的小孩子。那然后虽然说 Krishna 在她面前顶起了戈尔丹山，但是亚修的妈妈她也不会认为这是 Krishna 做起的，她就会说，嗯，这也许是我的丈夫帮她在后面把山给托起来了。
The effect of Yoga Maya is to allow the devotees to see Krishna as their friend, or as their lover, or as their child.
那所以说呢，这个 Yoga Maya 它的职责呢，就是为了要让爱 Krishna 的这个奉献者，看到 Krishna 是他的朋友，是他的爱人。
And in this way,
他的父母。
In this way, Lord Krishna enjoys loving dealings with his devotees.
那是 Krishna 就以这样的方式和他的奉献者们在享受着爱的互动。
So we see the two kinds of Maya acting in quite different ways.
那所以这样呢，我们就可以看到两种 Maya， 他们是以非常不一样的方式在运作着。
Now it's all Maya. It's Krishna's energy, just like electricity.Is one kind of energy, but electricity can be used in different ways. It can be used to heat, and it can be used to cool. It can be used, utilized to produce different effects.
但是呢，这个 Maya 它其实都是 Krishna 的能量，但是呢，它有不同的这个作用。那就好像是电，那么这个电呢，它是同一种能量，可是这个电呢，它可以产生不同的效果。它可以会就是发热，那它也会制冷。
It's all electricity, but the effects are different. In the same way, Maya, it's all Maya, but the effects are different.
那所以说呢，就是都是电，但是呢，电它会产生不同的效果，所以就跟 Maya 一样，就都是 Maya， 但是呢，它所产生的效果是不一样的。
So for the pure devotees, Yoga Maya is there.
那所以说呢，对于纯粹的奉献者，在他们面前展示的是 Yoga Maya。
They see Krishna as their son, or as their friend, or as their lover.
所以呢，就是在 Yoga Maya 的影响之下呢，使得纯粹的奉献者看到的 Krishna 是他们的儿子、他们的朋友，或者是他们的爱人。
But you've got the demons like Kamsa, and he's thinking, I want to kill Krishna.
但是如果是像康萨这样的恶魔呢，他想的就是我想杀死 Krishna。
The demons, they think of Krishna that, oh, we're going to kill him.
那所以呢，这个恶魔当他看到 Krishna 的时候，就在想，我得把他给杀了。
So this is Mahamaya.
这个呢，就是 Mahamaya.
Okay.
Yes, Marge.The next question, 顶拜咕噜的莲花族有时候呢 ，Krishna 有时候对 Krishna 很有信心，有时候那个信心就不是很足，怎么能够达到对 Krishna 的爱呢 ？Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. Sometimes I am very confident, I have full faith to Krishna, but sometimes the faith is not so very sufficient. So how can I actually attain the love to Lord Krishna?
Well, you have to become more steady in your spiritual practice by regular hearing and chanting, and you will get rid of the anattas, the contaminations from the heart, which cause these doubts, which cause the lack of faith.
就是你呢，应该是让自己的这个灵性的修习要更加的稳定。然后呢，要更加的有规律的念诵，以及诵读、聆听、念诵圣名，因为这样的话呢，就能够让你清除到内心的那些困惑。这个困惑影响了你的信心。
I don't know how long you've been practicing, but it, you know, it, you have to understand, you have to practice for a long time, and you have to practice very seriously, very intensely, and that way, then gradually we develop stronger faith.
我不知道你已经习练了多长时间了，但是呢，就是一般来说，这个习练呢是要非常要花很长的时间，而且呢，这个习练要非常的这个就是很努力使劲的这种习练，才有可能让自己建立起很坚定的信心。
Sometimes we can become very impatient about these things that we think, oh, I don't know, I've been a devotee already so many months and I haven't got Krishna prema yet.
那有的时候呢，我们可能就会有一些不耐烦了，我们就在想，哎呀，你看，我也不知道，你看，我都已经练了这么多月了，我都已经成了奉献者，成了这么多个月了，可是我到现在为止还没有得到对 Krishna 的 prema 呢。
But it's good, keep the desire, and one day Krishna will fulfill your desire.
但是呢，我们最好呢，能够有这个愿望，爱 Krishna， 然后有一天呢， Krishna 就会满足我们的愿望。 Next question, Maharaj.
Yeah.
The next question from Sugita Sangha Mataji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜故人的莲花族。 感恩翻译和主持人，谢谢您。请问 Maharaj， 一个人的秉性是 Maya 产生的作用，还是累生累世的业报使然呢？ Hare Krishna, please accept my humble obeisances to you, Guru Maharaj. My question is that the quality or the nature showed a person. Is that because of the Maya works on it, or is the karmic reaction from the lifetime's accumulation?
Yes, it's the lifetime's accumulation.
这是属于累生累世的业报的积累.
That we've been here in the material world a long time. So we accumulate a lot of karma. So, of course, that karma can be removed. Karma is not eternal. But it takes our pure devotion to get rid of the karma.
但是呢，我们必须要用我们纯粹的奉爱去，净化掉所有的这些业报。And
that pure devotion must be intense. It must be continuous. It must be unbroken.
而且呢，就这个纯粹的奉爱呢，它是要非常的炽烈的，而且呢是要持续不断的，是不能够被中断的。We
can't think that just oh, today I'm a great devotee, but tomorrow I'm too busy.
我们不能够想着，哎，今天我是一特了不起的奉献者，明儿我就太忙了。
It has to be every day. We have to be in Krishna consciousness.
对呢，这其实是一个每天持续不断的一个事情，就是每天都要让自己处在 Krishna 知觉之中。
Then through pure devotional service, then all that karma can be removed.
那所以说呢，就通过我们纯粹的奉爱服务，使得我们所有的这些业报就都被清除掉了。
Yes.
Yes. Sukhita Sangamaji, Guru 回答了您的这个问题吗？我不知道我刚才不知道是翻译有没有把您的问题给翻译准。如果要是您觉得没有翻译回答的话，
What was the first part of her question?
一个人的秉性是 Maya 产生的作用，还是累生累世的使然秉性？ The nature, sometimes the people, you know, will manifest a kind of nature or quality. Yeah, and she is asking for that type of nature. Is that because of the Maya created it, or the karma?
Yes, well, our characteristics, our nature is due to our karma.
Okay, okay. So then okay, okay. I'm a little bit not so sure that is I make you understand exactly what she's asking. 所以说应该是还是回答了你的这个问题了，就是这个秉性，就是我们的这个性格特征是由我们的业报所造成的。
嗯。
Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. 那下面这个问题是来自于 Darcy 的，关爱奉献者是关爱身体、心意还是灵魂呢？This devotee is asking, when we take care of devotees, do we take care of the devotee's physical body or mind or soul?
Well, both. When you take care of the devotees, yes, certainly you want to take care of their physical bodies. We also want to take care of their mind.
当然就是当我们要关怀这个奉献者的时候，我们是要关怀奉献者的身体，也要关怀他的心意。
Certainly.
And she's asking,
if you're going to take care of people, you want to be, make them feel comfortable. And by speaking nice words, kind words to them, that will be certainly make that will help their mind to feel peaceful.
就比如说，就是当我们在关爱奉献者的时候，那我们肯定是要让被关爱的这个对象感到舒舒服服的。那然后呢，我们要向他讲一些宜人的，益于他、取悦他的话。那这会儿呢，这个话语呢，就会让他的心意感到很舒服。
So if you're taking care of someone and you're not really, you don't have the right mood to take care of them, you didn't really want to take care of them, and then you may, you say things which are not very nice to them, and they'll certainly feel uncomfortable.
那比如说就是当我们要去关爱某一个人，但是呢，我们在关爱他的时候呢，我们的这个自己的这个心绪是不对的，就是我们根本就不想去关怀这个人的话，那我们可能就会说一些比较生硬冷淡的话，然后这会儿呢，我们说出来的这个话就会让对方觉得不舒服。
So we have to be very conscious about how to take care of people. That you certainly want to look after their bodies and give them a nice place to sit, and then give them some water, and then maybe make arrangements for their prasada.
那所以说呢，就是我们要有一种要关怀别人的这种意识。就比如说呢，我们在关怀别人的时候，关怀他的这个身体，就是要把他给他准备一个座位，然后呢给他献上水，然后呢再给他准备 prasada。
Yes, we're seeing here in the Chaitanya Charitamrita how to take care of devotees.
我们在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 永恒的 Chaitanya 经里面就看到了怎么去关怀奉献者们。
We see how they come, they bring sandalwood and flower garlands. When the devotees first came, they welcome them, give them a flower garland and sandalwood paste on their foreheads.
那比如说我们就会看到当奉献者刚刚来拜访的时候呢，我们要向来拜访的奉献者献上花环，并且呢在他的前额抹上檀香浆液。
This is culture there in that part of the world.
那所以呢，这个是在世界的那个地方的人们所展现出来的文化。
Right. You come to Jagannath Puri or you go to Vrindavan.They have so many flowers everywhere, and there's flower garlands everywhere. And people put a flower garland around your neck, and you're surprised that nobody ever gave me a flower garland before. But this is a culture.
那就比如说在文达文呢，在 Jagannath Puri 啊，其实有很多的花园，就有很多的鲜花。然后呢，这个那儿的人他招待客人的这个方式呢，就是给他戴上花环。所以当我们被人戴上花环的时候，我们就会觉得很惊讶，因为之前也没有人给我们戴过花环。
And when we do Prabhupada's Guru Puja every morning, we will put Prabhupada's flower garland on his round his neck, then we'll put the sandalwood paste on his forehead.
就每天清晨我们在给 Shri Prabhupada 做 Guru Puja 的时候呢，我们都会在Shri Prabhupada 的脖子上戴上花环，然后呢把檀香浆液抹在他的前额上。
And after we put the sandalwood paste on Srila Prabhupada, then we put it on the forehead of all the devotees.
然后呢，当我们把檀香浆液抹在 Srila Prabhupada 的前额上之后呢，我们就会把檀香浆液抹在所有的奉献者的前额上。
So this is very nice culture. This is showing proper respect and makes people feel happy.
那所以这是一个非常的美好的文化。这个是对所有的人呢表示尊敬的这个展示，让所有的人都会很开心。
People can you feel cooler and it's very hot. And you put the sandalwood paste on your forehead, it cools you down in the heat of the summer.
因为檀香浆液它是非常清凉的，比如说夏天特别的热，然后我们在前额上点上檀香浆液之后呢，就会感到一下凉快下来。
And then of course Everybody should be given prasadam. People come to the temple, we should give prasadam.
还有呢，就是应该给奉献者们准备，就是给人们准备 prasadam. 当人们来到庙里的时候呢，就要招待他们 prasadam.
Prabhupada said every temple, they should keep prasadam ready. When guests come, you have some prasadam to give them.
释迦牟尼佛说每一个庙里面都应该时刻准备着 prasadam. 当有人来拜庙的时候呢，就要给他们 prasadam。
And he said, you cannot say there's nothing. Every temple must keep some prasadam ready for guests.
而且呢，释迦牟尼佛说就不可能在庙里面什么都没有。每一座庙里面都要时刻都有备着的 prasadam 来招待客人。
So this is taking care of people, take care of their body and the mind.Take care of their minds by speaking nicely and welcoming them and showing a care for them.
那所以说呢，这就是又要照顾身体，要照顾心意。那么也就是说呢，这个照顾心意就是向他们这个献上宜人的益人的这个话语，让他感到听了这个话语感到舒服。Maharaj, she is actually is also asking.To take care of devotee, is that for taking care of the body, mind, or soul?
Well, we should take care of all aspects, all the parts.
那我们在照顾奉献者的时候呢，我们要照顾他的身体、心意和灵魂，都要包括了。
You can't just take care of the body and neglect the mind and the soul.
就我们不能够仅仅是照顾躯体，而忽略了心意和灵魂。
Or we just take care of the soul. We just say, "Oh, it's okay. I'll chant Hare Krishna to him. I'm taking care of his soul." And we don't give them any prasadam. We don't speak any nice words to him. We just chant Hare Krishna.
但是呢，我们也不能够就光说我只照顾你的灵魂，好吧？我就给你唱诵 Hare Krishna 就可以了。然后呢，我也不用跟你说一些让你开心的话，然后呢，也不用给你准备 prasadam， 就只是跟你唱诵 Hare Krishna 就可以了，这样是不行的。And then she continued to ask， 奉献者关爱是否也应该有个度，不能够过度过两个极端 ？But for taking care of the devotee， shall we have a kind of balance？ We are not supposed to go extreme。We should not take care of the devotee extremely.
Well, of course, you take care of different people according to their... Some people would be given more respect than others. Not everybody will be exactly the same. Some people will be given more care and attention than others.
对，就是我们在照顾奉献者的时候呢，当然也是还是不是完全一样的。可能有的奉献者他所得到的这个尊敬呢，可能比别人稍微多那么一点，可能有的奉献者他所得到的关注呢，可能比别人稍微多那么一点。
You may say, well, everyone's equal. Okay, so open the doors, let all the beggars come in, and all the beggars come in. And all the other people go away because they say, I'm not going to just sit there, I don't want to just be with all the beggars.
那也许可能我们会说，现在我们在回答的是 Dasi 和下面这个问题，奉献者关爱是否应该有个度，不能够过度或两个极端。然后我Guru就说呢，那也许可能我们就会说，那我们觉得是不是人人都平等吗？那如果人人都平等的话，那我们就是把庙门打开，让所有的这些乞丐全都进来。但是这样就会引起有另外一些人可能不开心了，他觉得那我不愿意跟所有的这些乞丐们坐在一起。
嗯。So.Proper respect for everyone according to their positions.
那所以说呢，我们要根据每一个人所处在的这个状态，对每一个人致以相应的恰当的敬意。
Just like dogs, you know, we don't like dogs in the temple. We can give them prasadam, but we don't let them come in the temple.
比如说像狗狗。那么这个我们要给狗狗提供 prasadam， 但是呢，我们不希望狗狗走到庙里面来。
So, you may embrace the devotees, we don't embrace the tiger.
比如说，我们会拥抱奉献者，但是我们不会拥抱老虎。
So we have to be a little intelligent about how to deal with everyone.
所以说呢，我们如何去应对每一个生物的时候呢，我们必须还是有一些智慧的。
Try to understand how to apply the etiquette.
所以呢，我们要努力的去理解如何去遵守我们的礼仪。
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Chandra Velan Sunni Mataji's question. 请教咕噜。我们做奉爱服务，如果没有百分之百的纯粹服务，是不是也会根据臣服的程度和纯粹的程度，也有相应的业报呢？感恩咕噜。Guru Maharaj, my question is that when we are doing the devotional service, if that devotional service is not 100% of the pure devotional service, will that not so pure devotional service will also get some?Corresponded reaction from those deeds based、
yes.
on the level of surrender and the level of purity.
Yes, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, as you surrender unto me, I reward you accordingly.
那么 Sri Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》里面说到呢，就是根据你对我皈依的程度，我会给你相应的回应。
Now, if you sacrifice everything for Krishna, then certainly Krishna will be taking care of you.
如果你要是把一切全部都这个为 Krishna 而牺牲了的话，那 Krishna 一定会照顾你的。
And Krishna knows how much we're giving and how much we're holding on.
因为 Krishna 他知道我们给了多少，然后我们手里边还攥了多少。
So we have to understand, if we want to get the full protection, the full mercy of Krishna, we have to give everything to Krishna.
那所以呢，我们必须要明白，如果我们要是想得到 Sri Krishna 的完全的保护、完全的仁慈的话，也就意味着我们要把所有的一切都给 Krishna。
So.You want to get the greatest mercy, you have to give the greatest. You have to give everything.
就如果我们要是想要得到最大的仁慈的话，那也就意味着我们要给予最大的奉献，我们要把一切都给予。
Krishna says, I carry what you lack, I preserve what you have.
那 Krishna 说呢，我会保护你所拥有的，并且提供你所需要的。
That is for the pure devotees who have given everything, who are fully absorbed in thinking of Krishna.
那么这个呢，是针对于纯粹奉献者说的，就是对于那些完全的将自己沉醉于对于 Sri Krishna 的冥想中的那样的奉献者，他给出了这样的承诺。
Krishna said, surrender unto me. I will free you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear.
Sri Krishna 说呢，向我臣服，我将把你从一切业报中解救出来，不要害怕。
So that is, if you give up all the material things, all the material conditions, you give up all that consciousness, and just take full shelter of Krishna.
那所以是就是这意思呢，就是我们放弃所有的物质的依附，放弃我们所有的物质的条件的这个限制，然后呢，让自己完全脱臂在 Sri Krishna 的保护之下。
But you don't. You think of Krishna. You think of Krishna 10 minutes a day. Then Krishna will think of you 15 minutes a day.
然后呢？但是呢，就是比如说你一天中呢想 Krishna 想十分钟的时间，那么 Krishna 在这一天里面呢，可能就会想你想15分钟。
Or you think of Krishna 4 hours a day. Krishna may think of you 5 hours a day.
但是如果你要是在这一天里面呢？想 Krishna 想4个小时的时间，那么 Krishna 他可能就会想你5个小时在这一天。
So as you surrender, Krishna rewards you accordingly.
那就是根据我们所皈依的程度 ，Krishna 会给予相应的回应。And Dasi ask, 我臣服90%，剩下10%有没有业报？She's asking if I surrender 90% for the leftover of 10%, will still create any karmic reaction?
Yes.
会的，有。
Yes, you still got some. Of course, because you're holding on, you've only given 90%. You didn't give everything.
因为你还不是没有完全，你还因为你还有保留，你只给了90%。
And so 10%, you're still on the material platform.
那所以呢，这个10%，您还有10%，依然是处在物质的层面上的。
Of course, Krishna can help you.
Can help. 那当然 ，Krishna 可以帮你。
The karma he gives you will be to help you to give up that 10%.
就是那 Krishna 他给你的这10%的这个业报呢，是会来帮助您把这10%的还没有给他的这个东西给放掉。
Because Krishna sees that 10% is holding you back.
因为 Krishna 他可以看到，其实就是这10%抓着把你给抓着那儿，让你止步不前呢。
So Krishna thinks, why have to hold on to that little 10%?
所以说 Krishna 在会想，他为什么还要抓着那点百分之十不放呢
？Why can't they just give up everything and take shelter of me?
他为什么不能够把所有的一切都放掉，然后呢，完全的在我的保护之下呢？
Okay.
Yes, Maharaj, there was a last question. A devotee from yesterday, she asked that what is the best way to discard the flowers offered to the deity? And then she asked if it's okay to use those flower petals to take care of our own feet. That like soak it in the hot water and put the flower petals in the hot water and use that hot water to soak our own feet.
Yes, you could do that.
Can use the flower petal water to soak our own feet, right?
Yeah, these flowers have been offered to Krishna. It's prasadam.
Okay, good.
First of all, put the flowers on your head and then put them in the water.
Uh-huh. Okay, 是这样的啊，就是昨天有位奉献者他问这样一个问题，就是这个供奉给 Krishna 的这个花怎么处理？ 因为咱们一般来说呢，都是把这个花呢给扔到这个花园，就是给埋在花园里面，或者是把它给撒在河里面。然后呢，这位凤姐她就觉得这个花瓣太可惜了，所以说呢，她就问能不能用这个花瓣来泡水，然后呢用这个水来泡脚。然后刚才我就问了一下马尔行不行，马尔说这么做是可以的，因为这个花瓣呢是供奉过给这个神像的 prasadam。 首先呢，我们先用头去顶拜这些花瓣，然后呢就可以把这花瓣给放到水里面，然后这个水就可以去照顾我们自己的躯体。
Yeah, generally after flowers are offered to Krishna, then we would like to put them into the either put them into the seaor into a river, or else we would put them, bury them in the ground.
通常来说呢，就是我们供奉过神像的这个花呢，是把这个花瓣给，或者要不然就是撒在海水里面，或者是河水里面，或者把它给埋在土地里。
Yeah. So many places they won't like you to put the water, put the flowers into the river, because it, you know, it's becomes.Can block, you know, damage or choke up the river if you have a lot of flowers in the river.
但是呢，有很多地方的这个河水，它就是一个管理者，其实不希望我们把这个花给撒到河水里面的，因为它有可能是会堵塞河道的。如果有太多的这些花投在里面的话
，But you can always bury them in the ground.
但是呢，我们也可以把这个花瓣给它埋在地里面。
Because they come from the earth, the flowers grow from the earth, so they can go back to the earth.
这个花呢，它是由土地里面生长出来的，所以呢，它们还是可以回归到土地里面去。Yes, Marge.
Okay.
So, yes, all of the questions has been answered. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.Thanks to Danakili Mataji for her wonderful translation, and thank all the devotees for their questions and their hearing and participation. We'll be back in the next.
非常非常 ，Yeah， 非常感谢所有的奉献者们的聆听，非常感谢大家的参与以及询问的这么多的好问题。我们下午再接着回来。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada ki. Go back to Vrinda ki.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.